Good afternoon, and thank you so much for joining us for our Class of 2028 graduation ceremony. At this point, I'd like to invite Lorenzo Grew up to give you the pleasure of his speech. Thank you, Lorenzo. Greetings and welcome, faculty, staff, community, and most importantly, our 8th grade graduating class of 2028. It is an honor to stand before you as your superintendent, who has the privilege of standing before you to provide these opening remarks. We have something in common. Your first day of middle school was my first day working with Chandler. As we entered two Saber Drive as wide-eyed but perhaps slightly nervous 5th graders, I too was walking around this campus still unsure of where I was going and honestly what I was doing. One of the many unique aspects of Chaumont can be found in its campus structure. While we have three campuses, two of them are attached, sharing everything from hallways to bus routes. With the district offices attached as well, I've been able to see you each and every day for the past 4 years. From the moment you set foot in your 5th grade classroom to the time you moved down to the 6th grade hallway, to your transition up downstairs where you became 7th and 8th graders, I was in the audience for your chorus and band concerts, ate breakfast at your quarterly awards, and saw your submissions at the Young Minds Expo. You did all the work, I just sat back and enjoyed the commiseration. Only a matter of weeks ago, most of you were at an 8th grade dance, a culminating experience that in many ways, especially in the appearance of a gym, which I barely recognized where we were, is like your version of prom. Your final hurrah before the summer starts, and in the blink of an eye, you are 9th graders starting your global studies homework. This event is symbolic in so many ways. Though it was your last middle school celebration, it's the continuation and start of many firsts. Besides the fun you had, let's talk about the decorations, food, photos, and frivolity that was put before you. While I'd love to say that it just appeared, we didn't hire somebody to come in and transform the gym and hallway into something of a catalog. It was your families, your school community, your friends, your neighbors, who spent their evenings and weekends to prepare for a night that was like no other. If you could indulge me for a moment, could I ask all those families who worked on the dance endeavor to please stand up, Mr. and Mrs. Santa Barbara, Mr. and Mrs. Grew, Mr. and Mrs. Angelosi, Mr. and Mrs. Mulosi, and Mr. and Mrs. Carney, anyone else that I didn't mention, please, if you could stand up right now, please. For anyone else involved in that, please stand up. Thank you, Sal, and Ms. Melkart, if you want to sit down. Thank you. I was hoping to publicly embarrass you more for a bit, but again, I'm safely behind the microphone to do this. What you just saw, students, you could briefly see that, they're very humble and they sat down very quickly, is what makes Chaumont the special community it is. All these people standing, and many who didn't stand because they're too modest, love and care about you. Whether it's an 8th grade dance, a future homecoming game, concert, athletic contest, or awards night, these same people, along with every staff member you've met and will meet at Chaumont, are standing with you, standing beside you, standing behind you, cheering you on and pushing you forward, but always there to catch you if you fall. Celebrating the great times, but equally there to comfort you in times that might not be so easy. So it's not just a bunch of people getting together to try their hands at decorating a gym. It's a metaphor that says, we are Chaumont. Having been in 4 other school districts, trust me when I say, you won't find it anywhere else. To say I, or better yet, we, are proud of you would be an understatement. You are unique, you are thoughtful, you are creative, you are athletic, and most importantly, you are kind. I speak for the high school in that I have no doubt that when you simply are moving down in the connecting hallway to continue your educational journey as 9th graders, you'll be a wonderful addition to Chaumont High School. And I hope it goes without saying that if you ever need anything, we are here, though as part of your past and your present, to support you in every step of the way. Congratulations, class of 2028. Today is your day, and so are forever tomorrows. Make it a great one. Thank you. At this point, I'd like to invite Ms. Lauren Shepherd up to the podium.
Hello. The first first award will be the President's Education Award. This award is given to students in middle school who have achieved a 90 or higher average in grades 6, 7, and 8. Here is a message from President Biden. Jill and I are happy to join your family, friends, and teachers in congratulating you on earning the 2024 President's Education Award. This year, you have shown curiosity, persistence, and determination to succeed. I hope you all are proud of what you have accomplished. Whatever path you choose, keep working hard, believing in yourself, and remembering that there is nothing you cannot do. Will the following students please rise and remain standing? Please hold your applause until all names are announced. Abigail Adair. Caitlin Alderdice. Liam Anderson. Vincenza Angelozzi. Eason Baker. Jocelyn Barber. Aubriella Blanchett. Matthew Bobar. Adriana Boss. Kyrie Brennis. Connor Brooks. Annabella Brunette. Michaela Carey. Aliana Carney. Michaela Coons. Warren Curtin. Olivia D'Agostino. Jaden Daly. Cipriana Demania. Lily DeRocher. Lydia DiCarlo. Gabriella Di Donato. Addison D'Ortona. Dylan Iser. Alex Fitzpatrick. Noah Galea. Kaylee Garrow. Mia Gilbert. Julian Nandowski. Ava Goodwin. Lorenzo Grew. Mariana Hines. Anna Homer. Alexander Horning. Jack Hughes. Owen Keith. Kira Kelly. Nathan Ketchum. Ahmad Khan. Crystal Kegler. Lucas Kovaleski. Lucas Kruger. Joel Kushner. Hannah Lansing. Amelia Lawson. Abigail Leroy. Angelina Lombardi. Cheyenne Luther. Brendan Mikett. Stella Malozzi. Shakina Matherin. Sarah Matice. Evan McClymans. Chloe McDaniel. Andrew Messley. Amelia Mickle. Brenna Mickle. Reagan Mickle. Cooper Montrum. Ryan Muse. Leanna Olson. Mason Panarese. Sophia Panica. Hannah Payton. Ashton Pettinati. Sean Perry. Harper Pierce. Michaela Priest. Isabella Kiernan Allende. Lucy Reese. Anthony Riano. Charity Salzberg. Bella Santa Barbara. Lucas Selnow. Mohammed Shami. Nicole Steele. Olivia Stubbs. Amelia Sturgis. Kelsey Surin. Melania Tabano. Libby Tresick. Lauren Tur. Niyamika Undemwa. Caitlin Villano. Yair Volquez. Alice Watson. Lucy White. Lars Wiedeker. And Juliana Williman. Congratulations. Please welcome the next presenter, John Urbanski.
Good afternoon. The Students of the Year Award is sponsored by the Chalmont Teachers Association. The 8th grade students were nominated by the entire faculty and considered to be outstanding in the following criteria. Outstanding character and attitude. Setting an example for others and conduct, service to the school, attendance, participation, and having an overall average of 90 or better. The two students who are recognized as the Students of the Year will each receive a $100 award, and their names will be recognized in the middle school with past winners. I know, it is exciting. Please hold your applause until both winners have been announced. I am going to say their names just to speak about them for a few seconds, but please hold it to the very end. Do your best. For those of you in my eighth grade class, we do lots of exercise and self-control. We can do this. Here we go. Our first student of the year, Brendan Mikett, is described by his teachers as upbeat and always willing to help out. They say he leads by example with honesty, respect, and good sportsmanship. His teachers add that Brendan's positive attitude makes a world of difference in the classroom. In addition, he always looks for moments of growth, takes on challenges with enthusiasm, and brings a sense of joy that brightens any room he is in. Our second student of the year, Stella Malozzi, is described by her teachers as generous, enthusiastic, and the first to help anyone in need. Whether this is organizing the class binders in social studies, which Mr. Gibbs wanted me to tell everyone are regularly destroyed by the seventh graders the very next day, she always helped out. She participates in class, or even volunteers to wear the Ronald McDonald costume during a Ronald McDonald House fundraiser. Stella is someone who demonstrates her polite and kind nature each day. As her science teacher, Mrs. Bryson, said, Stella is a photon of light, an energy source that shines bright. Please join me in congratulating this year's Students of the Year, Brendan Mikett and Stella Malozzi. Please welcome to the podium, Mrs. Romano.
Recognizes the character, courage, and commitment of New York's hardworking students. These students excel in their academic pursuits, participate in community service, display leadership among their peers, overcome personal challenges, and inspire and provide hope for the future. The three recipients for the 2024 Triple C Award are Abigail Leroy, Melania Tabano, and Cooper Mantra. Of the middle school guidance office for over 2 years. She also worked in the high school attendance office before coming to our middle school. Unfortunately, in July of 2013, Mrs. Dolly passed away from complications due to breast cancer. She was a compassionate, helpful, kind-hearted person who always treated others with respect. She also had a great sense of humor and loved coming to school every day, even on days when she didn't feel well. She loved her family most of all, but also referred to Shelmont students and faculty as her extended family. It is my honor and privilege to present this award to one male and one female who demonstrate the qualities of Mrs. Doley on a daily basis. Each student will receive $75 and their names will be displayed on the plaque outside of the guidance office. Congratulations to Owen Keith and Chloe McDaniel. Our next presenter, Ms. Lindsay Clark. The New York State Comptroller's Achievement Award is presented each year to a student who has excelled academically and has also shown leadership potential by volunteering his or her time to serve their school or community. Comptroller DiNapoli sends his sincere congratulations and best wishes to the 8th grade class. The recipients of the New York State Comptroller Student Achievement Award are Lorenzo Grimm, Ahmad Khan, Jocelyn Barber, and Caitlin Milano. To you, the class of 2028. On behalf of your teachers, we would like to thank you for an awesome year. I am honored this afternoon to present the Paula Selkis Memorial Award. This award was established in the memory of Mrs. Paula Selkis, a math teacher at the middle school for 28 years. She passed away due to a short battle with breast cancer. I was Mrs. Selkis's only student teacher during her career. She helped to lay the foundation for me to become the teacher that I am today. This award honors her and her dedication to teaching. The recipients of the Paula Selkis Memorial Award are chosen from a group of nominees from 8th grade and are found by the faculty committee not only to be outstanding math students, but also possess the qualities that Mrs. Selkis valued in her students: a positive attitude, honesty, responsibility, and enthusiasm. There is one winner chosen from each 8th grade team. Each recipient will receive $100 and their name will be inscribed on a plaque on display in the middle school hall. I am honored to present the Paula Selkis Memorial Award to the following students: Crystal Kegler and Lucy Reese.
Yes, Lucy!
Hello.
Yes, Crystal!
Achievement Award is presented to a student who has shown great progress in community service and or extracurricular activities. The Albany City Lodge, number 540, Knights of Pythias and Valiant, for community service and or extracurricular activities is presented to Reagan Nickel.
Sadness that our time spent together in middle school is coming to an end, and excite me as we enter a new chapter of our lives together in high school. 2028 seems like it is a far off date into the future, but it will be here in no time. Let's make the most of the rest time we have together in high school and create more memories together that last a lifetime. Congratulations, everybody.
Hello and good evening, staff, classmates, and families. I'm Bella Santa Barbara, one of the Sergeant-at-Arms for our middle school student council. As we, the class of 2028, move on to a new chapter together, I wanted to acknowledge one of the most memorable nights of our 8th grade year, the 8th grade dance. We all eagerly were waiting for this night to come. The dance was well worth the wait. It was such a fun experience for everyone who was able to attend. This school event was absolutely perfect. The feelings of excitement began to increase as we walked through the hallway, which had been turned into a well-decorated tunnel, leading us into the gym. When we first saw the gym, we were all left speechless. There was no way to describe the extraordinary decorations, the multiple photo booths, the numerous food choices, the DJ, and of course the best part was we all got to be there together. We danced the night away with some special guests on the dance floor. Shout out to all the teachers for making our night even more special with your amazing dance moves. We also got to gather around and see pictures of all of us throughout the years as we have grown up into the people we are today. The dance gave everyone a chance to dress up nicely and be a part of an unforgettable memory. Based on how fun our 8th grade dance was, we all can already tell how much fun it will be for us to attend the junior prom in just a few years. Being able to see the gym that we have played PE in for the past 4 years turn into a magical space, all because of the hard work from the dance committee, was a very special memory for all of us. We all the parents that gave their time a huge appreciation. So thank you to all the volunteers for helping us by getting food donations, drink donations, and decorations to make this night a once-in-a-lifetime event. The dance would have never been as special without all of your dedication. It's hard to believe that our middle school journey is coming to an end, but it's safe to say that each and every one of us have made a tremendous amount of forever lasting memories. Congratulations, everyone.
Good afternoon, teachers, families, and classmates. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Allie Carney, and I am the secretary of this year's student council. I'm so happy to pay tribute to all that we have experienced here at Shallow Middle School. There have been so many memories that we have shared throughout our 4 years here, but as I reflect on our journey, the most memorable year for me was this year. This year was packed with so many fun things like dodgeball tournaments, homecomings, spirit weeks, our field trip to Hudson Valley, New York City, and Hershey Park, where we spent the day riding amusement park rides and hanging out with friends. In the middle of the year, we also hosted a special day for our veterans. Many of our classmates participated in making posters and setting up the cafeteria for our Veterans Day breakfast. We made it so our veterans would never forget this day, as these brave men and women have selflessly put their lives on the line to protect our freedom. Many students also had the opportunity to participate in different team sports. Personally, I was also a part of our amazing basketball team that was undefeated this year, going 13-0. Coach Medusi did a great job of bringing our team together. She encouraged us to do our best and made a positive experience while teaching us the values of teamwork and commitment to supporting each other during every game. Eighth grade has been a year where we have learned so much. Specifically, my math teacher, Ms. Gander, gave me the words of wisdom when working with slopes. Always stay puff-puff positive when going uphill and nice negative when it's going downhill. Ms. Deming teaching us not to be a metal, Ms. Sennett telling us to stay gold, and Mr. Coco always having funny jokes to make social studies more interesting and fun. In closing, I would like to thank my classmates, my friends, my family, and most importantly, our teachers, for always encouraging us and supporting us throughout our 4 years here. I can honestly say that if it weren't for these people's daily support, we wouldn't be where we are today, headed for the challenges of high school after the summer. Thank you and congratulations to all of us on this fantastic year.
Hi, my name is Lorenzo Drew, and I am the Shawmont Middle School Student Council President. I would like to thank everyone here supporting the class of 2028. Without our family, friends, and teachers, we wouldn't be where we are today. It's hard to believe that 9 years ago, many of us were meeting each other for the first time in the Jefferson Playground at kindergarten orientation. Now here we are today, ready to close this chapter and start a new one, as we'll be in high school in just a couple of short months. It's crazy to think about how much we have matured since we started middle school, and it's almost hard to imagine what we'll look like in 4 more years. In high school, we have the opportunity to choose specific classes and extracurricular activities that will start to help us see what we want our futures to look like. We've already started this as we all had the chance to meet with our guidance counselors this year and pick which classes we want to take in our first year of high school. We are lucky because Shelmont offers so many different classroom clubs. So whether you're interested in business, science, art, music, sports, or various trades, Shelmont has a path for you to take. These last 4 years of middle school may have already sparked some interest into what our future may look like, and whether those interests remain the same or take a completely different path, I'm very confident that will be what we will all be successful with. I don't know about you guys, but I know I'm excited for pep rallies, Friday night lights, and all the amazing memories we'll make in high school. So here's to a great next 4 years, and I know as long as we keep following our dreams, we will all do great things. Thank you.
I'm Mason Tanner Reese. I'm the treasurer for Student Council, and I'd like to introduce the 2024-2025 treasurer champ, Jackson Broussard.
I'm Vincenzo Pizzuto, vice president. Vice president, and I would like to induct the 2024-2025 vice president, Marina Volta. Student Council President, Sandy Cirilla.
Hello everyone, I'm Mr. Alden, I'm the chorus teacher here at Shelmont Middle School, and we have a special performance for you guys. We're going to start a new tradition. The 8th grade chorus is going to perform at the graduation ceremony, so we hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
invite Mr. Robert Burgess to present the Shawmut Friends of Music Awards. Mr. Burgess, thank you.
How about another great round of applause for this awesome music department? I'm here to present two Friends of Music Awards to two individuals. Each of them are going to receive a certificate and a check for $50. The first recipient of the Friends of Music Award is a well-rounded and talented individual. Her dedication and her craft is evident through her constant search to improve her abilities on multiple musical instruments, such as percussion, singing, guitar, and piano. She participated in Songwriters Workshop, where she created an original composition from start to finish. She's been a part of multiple extracurricular activities throughout the middle school, such as chorus, jazz band, and the NISMA Sola Festival, where she received a perfect score. She was also selected to join the high school concert choir, which is an audition ensemble. Everything that a student does has gone above and beyond our expectations. Her enthusiasm will surely be missed as she moves up to the high school, but we are sure she will go on to do many incredible things. We are proud to present Lucy Reese. Dedicated musician. His eagerness to learn and grow is reflected in his positive attitude in each and every rehearsal. He joined the marching band back in the fall and was a soloist at this year's spring concert. He successfully auditioned into the high school wind ensemble for his freshman year. His ability to balance his passion for music with other academic studies and other extracurricular activities should be commended. The music teachers at the middle school will surely miss his artistic leadership, but are excited to see him accomplish even more over the next 4 years at the high school. We proudly present Joel Cooper. Yeah. Actually, our next one will be Shawmut Friends of Library, Greer Primero.
Words. students do. This person models all of the qualities of a friend of the Shelmont Library. She consistently participated in library events, fundraisers, and programs like Summer Reading, Makerspace, and the Young Minds Expo during her years in middle school. Her love of reading and her positive attitude embody what this award is all about. And her name is Crystal Kegler.
Sports levels this 2023-24 school year. Please hold applause until all student athletes are acknowledged. Students, please stand when you hear your name called at the meeting stand. I'd like to honor the following athletes: Caitlin Alderdice, Vincenza Angelozzi, Allie Carney, Olivia D'Agostino, Lydia DiCarlo, Addison D'Ortona, Dylan Iser, Ava Goodwin, Anna Homer, Alexander Horning, Jack Hughes, Joel Kushner, Abigail Leroy, Angelina Lombardi, Stella Malozzi, Rael Martin, Sarah Matice, Andrew Mesley, Mason Panneries, Vincenzo Pizzuto, Liam Springer, Kelsey Surin, Melania Tabano, Libby Trestick, Caitlin Villano, Layla Williams, and Juliana Williman. Congratulations. Congratulations. I'd like to welcome our assistant principal, Mr. Julie Gomara.
Folks, before we turn it over to Mrs. Zumar, for the next part of our program, Ms. Jackson does send her regrets, but we'd like to present one final award for today. That is the Daughters of the American Revolution Award. This organization was founded in 1890 with the simple mission of promoting historic preservation, education, and patriotism. These timeless overarching principles keep the DAR strong and vitally relevant in this ever-changing world. We actually have two to present. We have our first one going to Stella Malozzi. And our second one, Garner Cooper Montrum.
Introduced by John Urbanski and Mrs. Kate Smith. As the students' names are announced, we ask that the students stand up, carefully approach the podium to receive their certificate of completion from administration and school counselors, and then you will return back to your seat. Family and friends, we ask that you please hold applause until all students have been announced so that the names can be heard. Again, congratulations to students, families, and staff.
Abigail Adair. Donovan Ahern.
Yeah!
I'm not sure.
We're going to hold that applause till the end.
My bad.
Caitlin Alderace. Shane Allen. Liam Anderson. Vincenza Angelosi. Eason Baker. Jocelyn Barber. Aubrielle Blanchette. Adriana Boss. Kyrie Brennis. Maddox Brennan.
Yeah, Maddox.
Connor Brooks.
Yeah, Maddox.
Annabella Brunette. Andrew Burrows. Benjamin Bushnell.
That's my son. Yeah.
I didn't skip one who was absent. I want to acknowledge Matthew Bobar. Kai Carey.
Oh, yes.
Michaela Carey. Aliana Carney. Samuel Pace. Kaylee Casillo. Chelsea Condon. Michaela Coons. Mia Ferraro. David Kasul.
Word, David, word.
Joao Kasul. Warren Curtin. Olivia D'Agostino. Jaden Daly. Eve Dalton. Cipriana Demania. Mia DiMartino. Lily DeRocher. Nicholas DeRossi. Alana DiRico. Anthony DeWitt. Lydia DiCarlo. Gabriella DiDonato. Addison DiOrtona. Dylan Iser. Taylor Elmendorf. Alex Fitzpatrick. Noah Galea.
So now we're cheering, but not.
Mark Galliana.
Slay, bitch.
Ava Garden. Kaylee Garrow.
Mark.
Ladies and gentlemen, I want to make sure everyone can hear their name and have that recognition. Thank you. Julian Nagowski. Sorry, Nadowski. Liliana Rivenberg. Sean Perry. Christian Golden. Ava Goodwin. Perry Grabkowski. Shaley Gravel. Again, ladies and gentlemen, I want to make sure we give each one of your classmates their time. Lorenzo Groom. Yeah.
Mariana Hines. Anna Homer. Alexander Horning. Jack Hughes.
Dan is that guy.
Anastasia Hunt. Azalea Johnson. Owen Heath.
Coach, get to the bars.
Kira Kelly.
Kira!
Madison Ketchum. Nathan Ketchum. Ahmad Khan. Jazayana King. Crystal Keckler.
Coach Pete in the park.
Lucas Kovaleski. Lucas Kruger. Joel Kushner.
Yeah, Joel.
Kevin Lashman. Amelia Lawson. Abigail LeRoy. Angelina Lombardi. Ariana Lutchman.
Yes, Ari!
Cheyenne Luther.
Brendan Micah. Blake Martell.
Grandma.
Nicholas Noble.
Sophia Panica. Mateo Petricoli. Vincenzo Pizzito. Harper Pierce.
Congratulations, everyone. Now a round of applause.
Everyone that's here before you, our award presenters, ready to make this happen, our main office secretaries. Like I said, all this takes many, many months to organize. I want to thank them all. A round of applause for those organizers. Well done. This concludes our ceremony. Have a wonderful summer. We will see you next year. Well done, class of 2020. Thank you. Thank you.